question that keeps coming up again and again whenever I start doing custom EQ correction curves for headphones, or if I analyze a room with Room EQ Wizard and I want to do a compensation curve on an EQ, is that it's easy to host plugins on the end of your mix bus or your monitor bus to do the correction, or host a crossfeed simulator like Goodhertz CanOpener. But how do you do it for the rest of your system audio? This is why a lot of people won't stray away from using Sonarworks, because of its system-wide capabilities that route your system audio. So programs like Spotify and Tidal that you might be playing reference material, and you have that going through the corrective curve as well as the stuff that's coming from your DAW. Well, today we're going to look at exactly that, how to do it for both PC and Mac, and on both platforms there's a way to do it that's absolutely free, well, at least at the minute. So join us as we look how to route your system audio through plugin processing. Running system audio through a plugin chain on the Mac is actually really easy. Firstly, we're going to use a free program called Menu Bus. And unfortunately, this is now discontinued and unsupported, but it still works at this time. So, firstly, set your system audio to route through Menu Bus, and then open up the Menu Bus menu. Select your audio output, in my case, Quantum 2, and then start adding plugins. So, ProQ 3, and pin it. And then Goodhertz CanOpener Studio 3, and pin it. It's still a little bit quirky, as the pinning doesn't quite work until you put the second plugin on. But there you go. And then we go down, load the LCD1 CanOpener settings, and then the settings for CanOpener. Also, by the same developer, is a program called Sound Source, and this is kind of next level. As if I bring it up, not only can I route system audio through and add plugins here, we can also do it on an application basis. So here I've got Apple Music playing, through to the Quantum, expand it out, add effect, Fab Filter, ProQ 3, add effect, Goodhertz CanOpener Studio, and there you go, we can complete the chain that way as well. Running VST plugins on system audio in Windows is a bit clunky, but free, so no complaining there. What we're going to need is two different programs. Firstly, VB Audio's VB cable, virtual audio cable, and this is to link up system audio into VST Host, which looks like it was started in 2002, and it was, but there is a 64-bit download. So I've got both of those things installed. First thing to check is that we are routed through to VB Audio cable, and we do that in sound output. So I want to go to cable input on the settings there, and then open up VST Host. And I've got an empty window here, and now we're going to start configuring it. So firstly, go to devices, go to wave, and I want to set the input to cable and the output to whatever my sound device is, in which case this case is the main output of my Presonus Quantum. So okay that, and now let's this is the input, that's the output, and now let's get some plugins in the middle. So new plugin, Crave EQ, and then new plugin, CanOpener Studio. We're just going to drag that over and drag that over. Going to drag a line between them. Going to drag a line between there. Even though there is two buttons here, it's not left and right. It just means you can multiple do crazy streams that you're not going to want to. You're going to want to do a chain like this. So go into the EQ first, then into your crossfeed simulator, in this case, CanOpener. Press the little plug-in edit button. I've got some audio playing through. You can see it's being picked up there and then into CanOpener. Hopefully you are now enlightened as to how to run your system audio through a plugin processing chain for your correction. And if you've got any other questions about headphone mixing or anything else in general, I'm cooking, I'm quite good at barbecue, then drop us a comment and we'll get back to you. Don't forget to look out for the code word for some stonking deals if you're in the EU or the UK. Otherwise, thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you for another video again soon.